Well, today is the deadline for firms that are hoping to open full-fledged casinos in New York to submit their $1 million application fee. And the fight over who gets one of those licenses could become quite a hot debate over the next few months. Joining us now to talk more about it, our political analyst, New York Post state editor Fred Dicker. Now, Fred, we won't know until tomorrow the complete list of applicants for this. And some of them, I guess, they can get their money back somewhere down the line if they decide to drop out, at least for a short time. But it's kind of an interesting mix of companies and enterprises that want to take part in this.
Liz, it's huge. I mean, whether it's the E23 proposal for Albany or the one that the Saratoga Racing has for East Greenbush or downstate in the southern tip of Orange County where the real controversy may be, because Genting from Aqueduct today announced that it was going to be participating in this. This is going to be huge. Billions of dollars are involved. There are three sets of licenses to be issued, a total of four licenses, two in the Catskills, one in this area, and one in western New York. It's going to be very political, people fear. And while the governor's people, the gaming commission, as it's called, the new commission, claims it'll have a decision by the fall, chances are it won't be until after the election. I think we can be sure of that.
Now, Fred, how closely do you think they will stick to the whole idea of putting these casinos in areas that need that kind of economic boost?
Well, they're already defined in the law, so yeah. I don't think they have any extra obligation to stick to it. I mean, that's really the issue downstate in the Catskill region, where two major competitors now look like they want to put a casino, maybe worth as much as $1 billion, in the area of the Woodbury Common, which is only about 50 miles from New York City. But that's really not the Catskills. But the idea of the proposal in the Catskills region was supposed to be to benefit the Catskills. So you already have a lot of people in the Catskills very worried that they're going to be double-crossed. Now, there could be two casinos in the Catskills, but if it's going to be one at Woodbury Common, so near there, so close to New York City, why would anyone want to build one further north in the Catskills? That's a real serious question. It's going to be a political hot potato for the governor, as will some of the others. So that's why I think they're going to wait until after the election before making final decisions.
And do you think we'll be hearing a lot about it then in the meantime, or will this be a lot of, you know, behind closed doors discussions and political infighting?
Liz, I think it's going to be huge with tremendous attention, billions at stake. You can be sure U.S. prosecutors are going to be watching this. Local ethics monitors are going to be watching this along with the prosecutors. The press certainly will be watching this. And there's a lot at stake here. There are a lot of politics. But with billions of dollars involved, you could be sure all the rivals are going to be watching each other very carefully for any kind of funny business, special interest or influence that may be involved. You may recall what happened when David Paterson tried to award $1,000 for the Racino at the Aqueduct racetrack and the scandals that produced. It really almost got David Paterson indicted. It got some people indicted a couple of years later. So this is going to be watched very carefully.
All right, Fred. It is fascinating for sure, and we appreciate your insight. And you can get more of Fred's insight on the radio, live from the State Capitol weekday mornings from 10 to 11 on Talk 1300 AM.